Welcome to part two of Using Machines to Power Up Your Treatments. I'm Whitney Johnson.
And I'm Beth Bialko. In part one of this webisode series, we review the traditional electrical modalities that can be used to bring excitement and results to your treatments.
Today, based upon your questions and feedback, we would like to review a few advanced options and emerging technologies that are available in the industry. Please note that some of these modalities may not be available in your area and may also require additional certification, licensing, or insurance. We strongly suggest that before purchasing or using a device that you do your research and make sure it's a fit not only for your treatment center, but that it's within your scope of practice. Different states and countries all have varying regulation. It's important that with each regulating agency, the information obtained can help to prevent potential damage to your reputation, the client, and your business. Some of the local agencies may include, but are not limited to, the Board of Cosmetology or Skin Therapy, Medical Board, and the Insurance Liability Company. The information about the various modalities we're going to be sharing with you today is for educational purposes only. We would like to share with you what is available so you are well informed and better equipped to make decisions about what to offer in your business. Always ensure that you are trained, working within your scope of practice, and have the necessary documentation and insurance before offering any of the following procedures to your clients.
With any professional treatment, a thorough consultation is essential. Advanced services may require additional questioning, documentation, or legal consent forms before the treatment. By keeping the consultation card and any additional paperwork like treatment logs continuously up to date, you will be able to chart your client's progress, and it can also serve as a vital legal record. When using the following modalities, there are a few key points that you will want to remember. First, check that there are no contraindications to receiving the treatment. Ensure that the device that you have selected is appropriate for the skin. Follow the manufacturer's directions, meaning that certain products may only be allowed with their machines or the service warranty could be void. Make sure that you are following the manufacturer's protocols and heeding to any cautionary steps or warnings. Again, as we go through the different modalities, please remember that we normally would not use all of the options in the same treatment. Let's first begin with exfoliation.
While chemical peels are not an electrical modality, many skin centers will choose to offer clients this advanced form of exfoliation and may even combine it with services such as microdermabrasion, IPL, or even before laser. It's also important to understand how chemical peels can be used alone and are an alternative to physical exfoliation. Today's agents for peeling are more cutting edge and commonly combined with various ingredients. For example, a peeling treatment can begin with a degreasing agent such as salicylic acid to prep the skin. Ingredients such as enzymes, lactic acid, and trichloric acetic acid are then applied in combination, often for a set amount of time, and may even be layered before they are removed with a neutralizing solution. Chemical peels can be used for skin concerns that may be contraindicated to microdermabrasion, such as pustular breakouts, telangiectasia, excessive skin, or if a deeper level of exfoliation is required. Microdermabrasion is a superficial form of physical exfoliation. Microdermabrasion could include the use of crystals, or newer machines incorporate the use of diamond tips, which are crystal free. Regardless of the type of exfoliation used, a vacuum suction will be used in conjunction, helping to remove the debris off of the skin. Microdermabrasion can sometimes leave the skin dehydrated and, if performed improperly, can leave track-like marks on the skin. The next generation of microdermabrasion that is emerging incorporates the use of serums or water to assist with exfoliation and improves hydration. This type of exfoliation is being referred to as hydrodermabrasion. Dermafiling is another modality that a skin therapist may choose to use. A dermafile consists of crushed diamonds on the end of a file, similar to a diamond tip microdermabrasion machine, but without any wires or tubes attached. For the professional, this can be an alternative to paying the high cost of a microdermabrasion machine. However, sterilization concerns or inflammation from excessive rubbing and heavy pressure are more likely to occur.
The following modalities that we will now be discussing are best performed in a medical environment or under the guidance of a physician, as these modalities require advanced knowledge of the skin, training of the device being used, additional insurance, and can possess a level of danger that could possibly occur. Dermaplaning is also a physical form of exfoliation. However, it can be combined with chemical agents like enzymes, chemical peels, or additional exfoliation ingredients for more targeted solutions. Dermaplaning is going to consist of a surgical steel blade applied to taut skin in a back and forth motion, removing debris, and it can also remove vellus hair. Areas like large moles, broken skin, or pustular breakouts should be avoided. While this technique may look simple, it's extremely important that you are trained before offering this service to your clients. If performed incorrectly, or if the client does not lay still, it's very easy to nick an area of the face, create a rash, or cause damage to the skin. Some treatments may combine dermaplaning with additional exfoliation agents. However, like all skin treatments, check the consultation card to ensure it's suitable for the client's skin and that it won't further irritate the skin or cause unnecessary peeling. Skin needling may also be known as collagen induction therapy, microneedling, dermal needling, or dermarolling. Regardless of the name, the device used contains fine, tiny needles and can be a pen or a roller. These tiny needles will range in length from 0.25 millimeters up to 2 millimeters. Skin therapists outside of the medical setting should only be using a device that falls within 0.25 millimeters to 0.5 millimeters. As the device passes over the skin, tiny wounds are created, which help to stimulate the skin and facilitate rejuvenation. If used with too much pressure or improperly, unnecessary fluids could be drawn. Lengths that are approved for the professional therapist are designed to create a controlled level of skin regeneration. Skin needling is ideally used to improve the appearance of wrinkles, acne scarring, hyperpigmentation, loss of elasticity, and sun damage. A few general points for your consideration. An understanding of how the skin responds to injury and inflammation before using skin needling on your client. Check for any contraindications like medications, health history, and sun habits. If your state does not allow the use of lens sets, needles, or permanent makeup, chances are this device may be out of your scope of practice. Avoid applying ingredients that could be potentially irritating or congesting to the skin following skin needling. These may include, but are not limited to, artificial fragrance, dyes, or color additives, emollients that use petrochemical byproducts, hydroxy acids, photosensitizing exfoliants, and lipophilic vitamin C.
Light-emitting diode, or LED, is a low-energy, non-ablative device that emits an exact wavelength into the skin to stimulate or energize cellular activity. This non-invasive procedure activates cells with pulses of low-level, non-coherent, and non-thermal light energy. The theory behind LED is that energy will stimulate the skin cells in a manner similar to plant photosynthesis, the process of taking light and converting it to food energy as plants do. Most of the lights available will be a blue light for acne or a red light used for collagen rebuilding and aging concerns. Newer technologies may include the use of a green or yellow light, which have been used for vascular concerns such as telangiectasia or broken capillaries. Since LED does not generate or use heat, it is commonly combined with other treatments such as exfoliation, IPL, and even laser. There's very little contraindications that surround this particular technology. The most important thing is to decide what light to use and when to incorporate it into your treatment.
Intense pulse light, IPL, uses flashes of light and will vary in wavelength, usually falling between 400 to 1400 nanometers. Cutoff filters within the handpiece will determine exact range, allowing IPL to be optimized for different applications and skin types. Once the light is absorbed by its selected chromophore or target, the tissue is then heated and later removed by the body. The wavelength used will depend on the client's specific concern. IPL may be used in different areas of the body for treatment of fine lines, pigmentation or texture concerns, hair removal, acne, and vascular concerns such as spider veins or telangiectasia. IPL device is considered as a non-ablative option. This means there is usually no downtime associated with the treatments as the epidermis remains intact. A few key points that should be taken into consideration. Check for any contraindications such as epilepsy, history of keloid scarring, or the use of photosensitizing medications. Check that the appropriate eyewear is available to the client and therapist to protect the eyes from the light. Clients will generally express feeling a slight sting or rubber band-like snap each time the IPL is triggered. This can be eased by using a numbing agent, cool air, or an ice pack on the skin.
We hope that you have enjoyed the information provided in this webisode on the different options available in the industry. Each of these modalities will require additional training, certification, and professional products that can all work together to provide effective results. Before investing into any of these devices, we highly encourage that you do your research and check with the manufacturer on any other requirements.
Of course, if you choose not to incorporate a device, your professional products and your hands-on techniques can still achieve and maintain overall skin health. If you'd like to receive a copy of notes from this webisode, please fill out the short survey on the link provided. Thank you for joining us
in the treatment room.